Paul Rivers, Sunshine Coast.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I'd like to take this time to inform members of this House of an historic event that took place in my constituency this past weekend. On Saturday, the Tla'amin Nation celebrated the treaty they signed with the province of BC and Canada. Hegus Williams, Hegus meaning the old and the new name for chief or community leader, spoke about his hope for the future of his community, invoking the memory of his father, the first chief elected under the Indian Act. It began with a ceremony outside the nation's new legislative building, a beautiful wooden glass structure just off the highway leading to Lund, in front of which are five totems, each with specific messages and meanings, paying respect to the ancestors and giving hope to the young and welcoming visitors. Following the totem unveiling, about 800 people gathered at the Evergreen Theatre, where chiefs from across BC and other parts of Canada came to celebrate the historic achievement, including Sechelt Chief Calvin Craigan and Klahoose Chief James Delorme, among others. Speeches, dancing, and drumming entertained everyone who assembled. Key witnesses were called forward to remember and tell of events they witnessed, including Sophie Pierre, former Chief Commissioner, and former Mayor of Powell River, Stuart Alsgard, who's widely credited with being a leader in municipal First Nations relations. The treaty was in the making for 22 years, and the pride of the accomplishment was clear on the faces of all those who came together. A key comment came from Grand Chief Ed John when he pointed at the empty chairs of the recently departed ministers and said, "This is not just Tla'amin's treaty, this is the treaty of Canada and of British Columbia as well." In other words, the honourable implementation of the treaty is required for it to be considered and seen as part of the reconciliation process. Also required is an indication that the 41% of First Nations who are actively involved in some process of treaty are in a process that will result in positive outcomes. That can be done through the appointment of a Chief Treaty Commissioner. In a move made last year, the province suspended the appointment of George Abbott prior to him taking on the role, and the role has remained vacant.
Thank you, Member.
Thank you, Madam Speaker.